Welcome everyone, Farmer Cop here. This is going to be just a quick test video. So a few questions that have kind of come up regarding precision farming in the new root crops. So obviously for the new root crops, if you use one of these guys right here that puts the ridges in the soil before you plant, you get a fertilizer state. So it adds a fertilizer state in base game. As you know, in base game, there are two fertilizer states if you're not playing with precision farming. So this would add one, and then you can add a second one with a fertilizer spreader. So what we're going to test here, I have precision farming loaded in. We have soil data for this one. This is as low as I could get the nitrogen on this field. So it's like 20 to 25, I think is the most on here. So there's, yeah, you can see 10, 15, 25 there. So there's not a lot of nitrogen on here. So what we're going to see is, in terms of everything, we're gonna do a couple tests here. So what we're going to do is we're going to run. I'm going to save the game exactly how we have it right now. Auto save is off. So I'm going to save it right now, just like that. Perfect. Then what I'm going to do is do one test where we do carrots on here and we do this first. I'm going to document if this actually adds anything to the nitrogen value. I'm going to document how many seeds we use after we use that. I'm also going to document how much fertilizer we use to finish off the nitrogen on this specific field. Then we're going to run the test again where we don't use this, and we're going to see if we use the same number of seeds and get the same number of fertilizer that we use and see if the harvest is the same by harvesting it. So basically, I have two possible outcomes I think are going to happen. I think that when you use this thing in precision farming, it's going to add nitrogen or require you to use less fertilizer to get the same nitrogen level. Or it's going to require, or you're going to get just a better harvest if you put this on there and use that. So that's kind of what I'm going to test. And I will let you guys know at the end, of course, with what I find out. So again, we're going to do one test where we run it with ridges, document how many seeds we use, document how much fertilizer we use, and document how much we harvest. Then we're going to run it again without using the ridges on the same field, same all the same equipment, everything like that, where we document again how much seeds, how much fertilizer, and how much we get off the harvest. So I'm going to run basically two harvest tests on here to kind of find out. So again, this isn't going to be a super long video, but for those of you guys that use precision farming and are wondering how it works with the new root crops, again, I'm not testing all the root crops. I am making an assumption that is going to work for all of them. So that's just the assumption I'm going to make, but we'll see and test here and see if we see any differences with using this or not. Because if you don't need to use this, why would you bother using it? It's just an extra step and extra equipment. So we'll go ahead and see. So yeah, I'm going to go and run that test and I'll bring you guys back in at the very end. All right. So the test is done and some surprising results. So, basically there is no difference. There's absolutely no difference. Ridging, if you are playing with precision farming, making ridges is a waste of your time. You're just using more fuel. So with ridges, I used 3.4 liters of seeds and no ridges was also 3.4 liters. With ridges, I actually used slightly more fertilizer. Now, I think this is within the margin of error. For everything on here, I'm going to say it's all pretty much identical because it's all within kind of like a very small margin of error. So I used 384 liters of fertilizer when I had the ridges. With no ridges, it was 378 liters. So 6 liters difference, that's really nothing at the end of the day. And then the harvest, the yield, was the same pretty much. So with ridges, I got a yield of 47,081 liters, and without ridges, I got a yield of 47,145 liters of carrots. So pretty much the same. That's, again, also within, well within the margins of error, just within a few liters there. So, yeah, I guess the conclusion of this video is kind of that. So, yeah, not a very long video, just a quick video to kind of show you guys the answer. But, yeah, if you are playing with precision farming, it is not worth it to do ridges. Don't do them. They're a waste of your time. They don't mean anything to precision farming. It's not currently a feature that's kind of implemented. So yeah, it'd be nice if, even if it didn't affect the nitrogen levels, because I get putting ridges in the soil, it's not really going to affect the nitrogen levels, but at least to my understanding, it wouldn't. But it would be nice if you got like, I don't know, like a 5 or 10%, 10%, 20% maybe. 20% is probably pretty reasonable. A yield bonus if you did do the ridging, just because that's, you're supposed to do it. So there's some sort of incentive. So again, I'm recording this on December 8th. Of 2023. So if you are watching this after this comes out, it may have changed if they updated something or anything like that. But as of right now, that is how it stands. So there you guys go. If you guys enjoyed this video, please drop a like down below. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button up on the screen to join the Farmer Cop channel and turn your notification bell so you don't miss any future videos that I may post. This has been Farmer Cop. Thank you guys for coming and for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.